everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Precious Angel. If you're new here, you're welcome. Today's video would be a mother and daughter dance. Well, before I post like the mother and daughter dance, I just wanted to give you like a backstory to because when I posted the video on my WhatsApp status, a lot of people were asking me, what made you cry like that? Was it so emotional and everything? But I just wanted to give you a backstory about like what made me cry, and also like a notes to brides, because a lot of things will happen on your wedding day. A lot of things happened on my wedding day that I just feel like I saved the tears for that moment, for this moment with my mom. So I just want to start up a series, God helping me, we work schedules and everything. I hope I can continue, but I just want to start up a series like titled Dear Bride. So things that you should look out for, things that you could avoid, things that would help you go through the process of your wedding day smoothly. Wedding planning tips are different from wedding day tips, because wedding planning, you can hear all the, be considerate, but the wedding day is more about protecting your own person, your own space. So literally, I'll just mention a few things that happened on the wedding day, like on the gong wedding day, that made me pile up my tears up until that moment when I had like the mother and daughter dance. So the first thing that made me pile up my tears was that I left my hotel actually very early, and I didn't get enough time to snap with like my bridesmaids and the groomsmen, you know, all those pictures that the bride has with her girls after they're finished wearing their clothes. I didn't have that because I was very paranoid about like going late for the wedding and stuff. But the thing that like just made me cry in my heart, I didn't visibly cry out, was that when I got to like the venue, I was too early, and I had to wait in the car almost doing nothing. Like I had to wait in the car trying to say people should not, like, I don't want to see people and all of that. I was so angry, but I was not happy, because why did I have to come too early? Another thing that made me unhappy, I'm not going to mention that, I don't even want to go into that. The other thing that made me unhappy was the MC. I had an amazing MC. I had the most amazing MC. But I had to go through the moment of suppressing like the tears that I could have cried to seeing how beautiful and amazing he was. Because after the church service, you know that other photograph where at least the MC will help you coordinate and tell you like this person should come next and all. The MC was nowhere to be found. I was looking for the MC everywhere. The MC was nowhere to be found. It was just a random person that just started saying, bride family, groom's family, and this thing. And I had, even without the list at the back of the program, I had already also given the MC like a comprehensive list of the people he's supposed to call, but MC was nowhere. I was like, where is the MC? It was nowhere to be found. So in that moment, I remembered something that I watched from, because in that moment I was already crying inside my heart, I'm not going to lie, but I remember something I watched from one YouTuber, and she was like, when you're going through that very hard time in your wedding, so that you don't have very bad pictures because you were frowning, you just have to do it like this too. In between crying, I was doing like this and all of that, and that's how it was becoming too much. And people, one woman was just, I'm going to give you guys that gist, some like maybe in another video, how someone was, you know how like YouTubers say when your wedding, don't just collect anything, because I thought it was a joke. Like, wait, I thought it was a joke until one man started approaching me with something. I'm going to give you that story like later on the later day, but she's approaching me with something, and I just zoomed off. I walked out, and oh, my family, my husband's family, God bless them, because I was so annoyed, and I apparently walked out of like my family, and I felt so bad later on. But what made me even cry was that when it was time to do the mother and daughter dance with my mom was just beat. My mom, she watched this video, she'll say, Angie, you're not forgiving me, you're calling me out. My mom was just so busy everywhere. Like, you could see that, like, I mean, I was just calm, but you could see that she was, like, literally everywhere. And when you said my mother and daughter dance, my mom was nowhere to be found. Apparently, I don't even know if she knew that there was mother-daughter dance in the program or anything. She was nowhere to be found. I mean, I just went out. I don't know why they didn't put that part, but if those that are in the wedding, comment if you remember. Like, I went out and started dancing ballet on my own, like, trying to not cry. And when my mom just came, finally, I don't know where they called her from. Oh, doctor, combo, you're supposed to be dancing, you're supposed to be doing. I just wailed. So, when, you know how, if when you watch the video, you're going to see, like, a very big sweet. You know how someone cries and they're like, I've cried enough, and I just started dancing. Actually, for me, it was really nice because the tears was made use at the right time. But it was such an emotional mother daughter dance, and that's that. So I'll start a bright series, hopefully, and I hope that you like it and it helps someone. Thank you.
You wake me up so I can spend the night. Sunday.